thank you for joining me. These YouTube clips are a labor of love, and I hope that you enjoy them as much as I do making them. The purpose is to help open up some doors, educate, but if they don't resonate with you, let them go and move on to the next. I hope you will sit back, relax, and enjoy. Thanks for watching. Kayla writes, how did you get these guides? Guides are assigned to us, and they are assigned according to where we are on our life projection and also what our life purpose is. Some will have more than others. It doesn't mean that they're better. It just means that they need support in various ways. I know psychics and mediums, for example, will have more because of the work that they do. Children, probably not as much because their life at the time is less complicated. But for the most part, when I read for people, I sense about two or three guides anyway, regardless of where you are in your life's purpose. And again, they are assigned to you. You don't have to look for them. Now, there is a difference between guides and guardians. Guardians are the people that you know. They are the ones that have passed before you, love you, and want to help you and support you. For instance, I have an uncle who was a self-made millionaire, and I ask him in when I need some financial assistance or advice. So he would be a guardian for me. But guides are normally energies you don't know. And funny enough, they don't have names. We as humans want to label them and give them names. They don't care. You do whatever you want. The best way to recognize them is through the energy and the purpose with which they are working with you. So say you're wanting to write a book. You'll bring in authors from the spirit world that will help you. And when you're done with your book, they'll probably move on because the purpose is finished. They're not your friends. They are guides, and they are here to help you.